Hi everyone, welcome to Rehope Games. I'm Murat. In this video, we'll get to know Rigidbody 2D. Let's start. I edit a ball to the scene. When we start the game in this way, nothing changes. If we want the ball to be affected by gravity and other physics laws, we must add a Rigidbody to it. I selected the ball game object in the hierarchy panel, then clicked on Add Component. We added a Rigidbody 2D to our ball. Let's start the game again. As you can see, the ball is affected by gravity. I want the ball to stay on the ground, so I will add collider to both ball and floor. Let's start the game again. Alright, let's get to know the features of the Rigidbody 2D. There are three options for body type: dynamic, kinematic, and static. Dynamic Rigidbody 2D is used for moving objects affected by gravity and friction and has a mass. A dynamic body will collide with every other body type and is the most interactive of body types. A kinematic Rigidbody 2D is not affected by gravity and forces. We prefer it when we want to move an object without being affected by the laws of physics, for example, a platform game object. Static body type is for objects that will not move at all. Let's take a look at the gravity scale. I'll clone the ball with Ctrl D shortcut. Let's change the gravity scale and see the results. Linear drag affect positional moment. Let's take a look at the example. Angular drag affect rotational moment. If you don't want the object to move on the x-axis, check the x-box in the freeze position. When check the y-box, the object cannot move on the y-axis. When check the z-box in freeze rotation, the object cannot rotate. Let's take a look at the mass. Check the box if you want the Rigidbody 2D automatically detect the game object's mass from its collider 2D. When you uncheck the simulated box, the object is no longer affected by gravity and its collider becomes inactive. Slipping mode and interpolate are unnecessary technical details. Prefer slipping mode, start awake, and interpolate none. I want the ball to bounce when it hits the ground, so I'll add a physics material to the ball. Drag and drop to material slot. Nice! As you can see, we add material both to collider and rigid body. If both have material, only that of the collider will be valid. Continuous detects collision faster than discrete, so if your object is moving fast, you should choose the continuous. I'll add code to the ball to control. and drag and drop to the ball game object. I'll shoot a detailed video about the movement system. I'll explain the codes here and more in that video. As you can see, the ball is slipping. To avoid this, we must increase the friction of the physics material. Your opinion is important to me. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. I hope this video was a useful content for you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.